We are joined by James Tupper from Mercy, the new show on NBC. James, good morning.
Big J, what's up? You know, that's my nickname, too.
Is it really?
Big J. Big J.
Yeah, James.
I get the J part. You're kind of giving us big guys like a bad name, though, when they've got a good-looking guy like you known as Big J. Then people think like, oh, that's what a Big J looks like, and then they see me, and it's like a disappointment.
Well, I don't know what to tell you, man. I mean, I think you belong in Hollywood.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that. You're doing a lot these days. I mean, you've been all over the place. People have seen you around, but you've got some big projects coming out. One of them, of course, is Mercy, the new show on NBC. For people that haven't got a chance to check it out yet, tell people what's going on with that show.
Oh, you know what? It's a medical drama. I like to call it a doctor show, but I think it's centered on these three nurses, you know, what happens? The hospital's in New Jersey. It's kind of underfunded, and it's a bit rough around the edges. And I think, these ladies are kind of helping people out. I think what the idea is that the doctors take care of you physically, and then the nurses come in and kind of help emotionally you deal with the problems. Like, I just had to amputate last episode. It wasn't good, man. It was not good.
Yeah, so then you just take off whatever body part it is. You head out and let the nurses deal with the fact that they just lost a limb.
Whatever I need to do. And then I'm out of there.
Yeah, you're a doctor.
It's different than most medical shows because it follows the people into their home lives. It goes into homes and families, and there's like brothers, and there's a bar, and you know, so it's kind of like it's dealing with both what happens in the hospital, and then 50% of it is what happens because of the hospital and the homeless, the people.
Cool.
And I basically play a doctor who just got back from Iraq. And I'm from California, and I just can't deal with my life there anymore, and I don't know where I belong, so I end up going to New Jersey. I follow this nurse that I kind of fell in love with in New Jersey.
Excellent. It sounds good. Sounds like a perfect mix of, like, ER, Grey's Anatomy, and Friends, all thrown into one.
Yeah. Yeah, a little bit of that. A little bit of Men in Trees.
Yeah, a little bit of it. I just like to throw Friends into everything there since it's old
school.
Totally, man. You're slated as Us Weekly's sexiest stars. TV Guide's one
of... How does that feel to talk to the sexiest... How does that feel?
It feels good.
Horrible.
It's a little intimidating.
Intimidating? You're kidding me. Listen, my dad read that and he's like, what the heck's that, Jimmy? What the hell are they calling you that for? I just don't... You have a way of seeing yourself, and that wasn't on my list.
Your dad's upset about it. Call these people and tell them to take that out of that magazine. You are not sexy.
I love that he just does it. It never even occurred to him. He's like, what the heck are they talking about? Why would they call you that?
There's another guy in Hollywood. He thinks there's somebody else using your name.
Right. Right. he lives in Nova Scotia, you know, and he's a carpenter. He worked in the school. Taught school for a while. He's a regular guy, and he's like, "This is just weird."
That's cool.
It's weird. It is weird, man. It's totally weird.
Is it hard on your like relationship, your family life when stuff like that comes out? Is there any jealousy or
only when I'm in trouble? Listen, the only time it ever comes up is when I'm in trouble, and I'm like, "Listen, lady, I'm like the top 5 ranked in Canada. Come on, show me some love." So that's it.
I bet that works out well for you.
Yeah, no, it's totally hilarious. She's like, will you stop making that joke?
Another cool project you got coming up I want to talk about a little bit. Me and Orson Welles, the movie with everybody in Hollywood in it. Tell us a little bit about that.
That was really crazy. Well, it's centered on a theater production of Julius Caesar in 1937. So it's a real period piece. And Orson Welles did this thing where he mixed fascism in with Shakespeare. And it got such attention that it launched him into a film career. And I think it's so simple. The story is so simple, but just like Richard Linklater, there's so much observation, small details. And I think it gives the audience a chance to participate in what it would be like to be in a wildly successful theater production on Broadway. Anyway, it's told through the eyes of Zac Efron. He comes into the company. And I play Joseph Cotton, the old-time movie star. And I kind of take him under my wing, and we do this production, it's such a simple story.
That's
and yet
cool.
In it is all of humanity. I love what he did because he got the DP from the Gilbert and Sullivan movie that they did years ago, and it's really smoky, and we went to the Isle of Man to find actually a period theater that matched the Broadway and we shot there. It was just wild in the middle of nowhere. But it kind of created a company feeling, a weird company feeling. I think the thing with theater is once you're doing it, you're kind of all a family in a little boat, you know, and you're struggling for survival, and everybody's doing everything they can to make this thing work. Because in success, everybody blows up, and in failure, yeah, no one has a paycheck.
Exactly.
So it's just about this one little production. It's so simple, but so well told, you know.
Very cool. Was there a lot of drama on the set between you and one of the other sexiest men on the screen, Zac Efron?
Oh, No, not at all. That guy is amazing, man. He's like Gene Kelly. Like, when he moves, you're like, wow, you're perfectly in balance every step you take. Like, he's got such a... It's not a dancer thing. I think Travolta had a little bit of it. I think Gene Kelly... When I met him, I was like, you remind me of a Gene Kelly. Like, if there was ever a guy who could... And he would do all these... So we had hats, you know, because it's the 30s. And he would do all these tricks with them when we were there. Now, he's a sweet guy, a hard-working guy. You know, I think he did this because he wanted to go out and try his acting chops, you know. But he matched up, man. He's a terrific guy and a great actor.
That's cool. That's what I've heard from. We had Thomas Lennon, the comedy guy, on the show when he was in 17 again with him, and he said the same thing. He's like, the dude's phenomenal. He's like just all around talented.
Yeah, he's all around talented. He's the real deal.
Very cool.
So,
I was going to say, can't wait to see.
You know, I do have to tell you this one funny story, because we were in the Isle of Man Theater, you know, and everybody's like, oh, I, how are you, you know, in this funny accent. And we're like, okay, fine. And basically, like, what it was like, it was like Beatlemania. Like, what happened was these 9 to 12-year-old girls figured out that Zac Efron was in the theater, and we were working on the scene together. And he would come out, and there would be a crowd of about 50 kids, like Islanders, screaming, like in that kind of Beatlemania way, like, oh, Zac, oh, Zac. And I felt like such an old dude, because they're like, do you know Zac Efron? And I was like, yeah, I know. Yeah, sure, I know him. I'm James Tupper. I was on Man in Trees, remember?
Yeah, I'm sexy
nothing,
too.
Nothing.
Can't wait to see that movie, me and Orson Welles. But also, we can check you out on NBC on the new medical or doctor drama, as you call it. Mercy, James, it's been great talking to you, man. Thanks for joining us on the Big J Show.
Thanks a lot, Big J, man. Thank you very much.
See you, James.
I'll talk
bye-bye.
To you soon.
The Big J Show, weekday mornings from 6 till 10 on Billings' #1 hit music station, Hot 101.9.